Good morning, students, and welcome to today's class. So in the last class we were doing multiplication and we saw how to do multiplication with a two-digit multiplier. Correct? We saw multiplication of numbers with two-digit multipliers. So what is the meaning of multiplier? Multiplier is nothing but the number with which you're multiplying a multiplicand with. Okay, so we saw how to do multiplication of a number by 10, 100 or its multiple. So whenever you're multiplying a number with 10, 100, what you do, you first multiply that, write that number as it is, and then you write the number of zeros, how many number of zeros are there in 10 or 100 after that number. So for example, 27 into 10. So we write 27 as it is, and in 10 we have 10. So we'll write 10 after 27. Okay, and in 48 into 100, we'll write 48 as it is. And there are 2 zeros in 100, so we'll follow it up by 2 zeros. So 4,800. And also we saw how to multiply a number with its, multiples of 10 and 100. So here we have 34 into 20. So what you can do, this 20 you can write as 2 into 10. So you can multiply 34 and 2 first. And the 10 has 10, so you can put 10 after the product. So this is one way of multiplying a number by 10, 100 or and its multiples. Okay, then we saw multiplication with two-digit multipliers. So here you have to find the product of 27 into 31. So first what you will do, we multiply each digit of the multiplicand. The multiplicand here is 27. So we'll multiply each digit with the ones digit of the multiplier. Multiplier is 31. Okay, so we'll multiply 27 with 1 first. Okay, so when we do that, 27 into 1, we get 27 only. Then we multiply the tens digit of the multiplier. Now in tens digit of the multiplier is 3 or 30, and insert a 0 at the ones place. So insert a 0 at ones place and then multiply 27 with 3. So 27 into 3 is 810. Now once we multiplied the numbers, what we'll do, we'll add the product. So 27 plus 810. So when you do that, you'll get the sum as 837. Okay, we get the sum as 837. So this is how you find the product of numbers with two digit multipliers. Then we also saw how to verify your answers. So we did a verification by using a method called digit sum method. What is it called? It's called digit sum method. So what is it? So to find, now we'll see this problem and verify it. So you find the product of 384 into 43. First what we did, we'll multiply 384 with 3. Okay, when we do that, we'll get 1152. Okay, then we'll multiply 384 with 40. So when we multiply, we'll get 15,360. Then we'll add 1,152 plus 15,360. We'll get 16,512. So the product is 16,512. So to find, to verify the answer, what we'll do? Find the digit sum of the multiplicand. So here the multiplicand was 384. Correct. So we'll do 3 plus 8 plus 4. How much is 3 plus 8 plus 4? It is 15. Okay. And 1 plus 5 will do. So we'll add till we get a single digit answer. So 1 plus 5 is 6. Okay. Then we'll find the digit sum of the multiplier. Here the multiplier was 43 and the digit sum is 4 plus 3, 7. So digit sum of multiplicand is 6. Multiplier is 7. Okay. Then we'll find the product of the digit sums. That is, we'll do 6 into 7, which is 42. Now if this number is, this 42 is a two digit number, so we'll do 4 plus 2, which is 6. Okay, 4 plus 2 is 6. Now find the digit sum of the product. Now here the product is 16,512, so the digit sum will be 1 plus 6 plus 5 plus 1 plus 2, which is 15. Then we add, find the digit sum of 15, 1 plus 5, 6. Now here the values in step 3 and 4 are same. Both are 6. So it means that your answer is correct. So this is how you do verification of your answers. Alright, so in today's class we will learn multiplication with three digit multipliers and estimation of product. We have done estimation of sum and difference. Today we'll do estimation of product. Now multiplication by three digit multipliers. So we know how to multiply by a two digit number. So let's see how to multiply with three digit multipliers. Now in two digit multipliers, we multiply the multiplicand first with the ones digit, then the tens. Now in three digit, we first multiply with ones, tens, and then hundreds. So there's one step extra here, and then we add all the three answers. So first here, 324 into 4 will do. 4 is in 1's place. So we'll multiply 324 with 4 first. So I'll multiply 4 with all the 3 digits in 324. So 4 4's are 16. So we'll write 6 and carry over 1. Then 4 2's are 8. 8 plus 1 9. So we'll write 9. 4 3's are 12. So I got 1296. Then what I'll do, I'll multiply with the tens digit. Tens digit is 1. So I'll multiply 324 with 10. That since it's in tens place, so we'll put 10 in ones place. Okay, and then we'll multiply 1 with 324. So we'll get 324 only. So 3240. Then we'll do 324 with 5. 5 is in hundreds place, so 500 it will be. So we'll put 2 zeros at the end, or we'll put zeros in tens and ones place. Okay, when we multiply 324 with 5, we'll get 16200. Okay, that is 162,000. Now once we get all these answers, we have to add them. So 6, then 9 plus 4, 13, so carry over 1, 1, 2 plus 2, 4 plus 1, 5. Then 1 plus 3, 4, 4 plus 2, 6, and the 6 and 1. So the answer is 166,536. So this is another example. 568 multiplied by 209. Okay, so 568 into 209. First we'll multiply 568 with 9. So when I multiply, I'll get 5,112. Okay, then 5 in tens place we have 0. So 568 into 0. Any number multiplied by a 0 is 0 itself. Correct, then 568 into 200. So when I multiply, I'll get 1,36,000. Now here I'll add 5,112 with 1,13,600. So when I add that, I'll get 1,18,712. So this is multiplication by three digit multipliers. Now we have estimation of product. Just how we did estimation of sum and difference, we are to by rounding of the numbers to tens, hundreds, or thousands place. We'll use the same method to find the estimated product. Now here we'll see an example. Here they've told estimate the product of 486 and 32 by rounding off to the nearest tens. Okay, and also find the actual product. Now to find the estimated product, they've told round off to nearest tens. So we'll round off both 486 and 32 to the nearest tens. So 486, when I round it off to nearest tens. So 486, rounding out off to nearest tens, I look at the ones place. Ones place I have 6, which is greater than 5. Correct? Which is greater than 5. So I'll add 1 to the tens place. So 8 becomes 9 and 6 becomes 0. So 490, we round it up as 490. And then 32. 32, when we round it off to nearest 10, we'll round it down to 30. Now what we'll do to find the estimated product, we'll multiply 490 with 30. Now here we'll multiply 49 with 3 first. So when I do that, I'll get 147, and there are two zeros. One zero here and one zero here. So I'll put those two zeros after 147. So my answer is 14,700. That is the estimated product. To find the actual product, we'll multiply 486 with 32 using our normal multiplication method. So when I do that I will get 15,552. So the actual product is 15,552, estimated product is 14,700. Alright, so this was multiplication by 3-digit multipliers and estimation of product. We'll see a few problems on this now. So, page number 121 in your textbooks, exercise 3.3. Okay, so here they've told estimate the product by rounding off to the nearest 10. So, they've given 4 problems, so we'll do all the 4 problems. And the second question is to multiply, and they've given a few questions here. Okay, so let's do these questions. Please copy, solve and copy to your class workbooks. So, exercise 3.3, question number 1. Estimate the product by rounding off to the nearest 10s. So, the first question here is 713 into 48. So, what we'll do here, we'll multiply 7, first we'll round off 713 and 48 to its nearest 10s. So, 713, when you round it off to the nearest 10s, you get 710. Now, 3 is in 1's place, which is less than 5. So, 10's place remains as it is, and the number towards its right are replaced by 0. So, that is 710. Then we have 48, correct? So, 48, when you round it off, 8 is in 1's place, which is greater than 5. 8 is greater than 5. So, we'll add 1 to the 10's place. 10's place, we have 4. So, 4 plus 1, 5. And it becomes 0. So, 50. Okay, so 48 is rounded up to 50. So, now what you'll do to find the estimated product, we'll multiply 710 with 50. Now, this you can use a shortcut method. You can just multiply 71 with 5 first. When you do that, you'll get 355, and we have 2 zeros at the end. So, we'll add 2 more zeros here. 1 zero from 710 and 1 zero from 50. So, it becomes 35,500. Alright, so this was question number A. So, copy it down please in your books. Okay, now question number B. 248 into 26. So, when I round off 248 to the nearest tens, 8 is there in 1's place. So, when I round it off, it's greater than 5. So, rounding it off to nearest tens, it becomes 250. 248 is rounded up to 250. And similarly, using the rules of rounding off numbers, 26 is rounded up to 30. So, to find the estimated product of the numbers, we'll multiply 250 with 30. So, when I multiply 250 with 30, what we'll do, we'll multiply 25 with 3 first. So, 25, 3 is 75. And then there are 2 zeros in the multiplicand and multiplier. So, we'll add 2 zeros after 75. So, that becomes 7,500. Okay, so the estimated product here is 7,500. Then, estimated product of 695 and 412. So, first we'll round off 695 to nearest tens. So, when we're rounding off to nearest tens, we'll look at 1's place. Now, here 1's place is 5, correct? And 5 is equal to 5. So, what we'll do? We'll add 1 to the 10's place. 10's place, we have 9. So, when I add 1 to 9, it becomes 10. So, I can't write 10 in 10's place. So, I'll write 0 and carry over 1 to 100's place. So, in 100's place, we have 6. So, 6 plus 1 is 7. So, 695 is rounded up as 700. Okay, then coming to 412. 412, 2 is in 1's place. So, rounding it up, 2 is less than 5. So, 10's place remains as it is. So, it is rounded down to 410. Okay, so to find the estimated product, we'll do 700 into 410. So, we'll multiply 7 with 41, which will be 287. Then we have 3 zeros, 1, 2 and 3. So, we'll add 3 zeros after 287. So, that becomes 287,000. So, estimated product of 695 and 412 to nearest 10 is 287,000. Here we are not finding the actual product of the numbers because they have not asked for it. They have just told to find the estimation of the product, right? Okay, then the last question, in question 1, 548 into 204. Now here we'll round off 548. So we round off 548 to the nearest tens by rounding it up to 550. Correct? And 204 is rounded down to 200. Now to find the estimated product, we'll do 550 into 200. We get 1,10,000. Okay, the estimated product is 1,10,000. Now question number 2 in your textbooks, multiply. So first question is 413 into 625. So here what we do, first we multiply 413 with 5. Okay, so when I do that, I'll get 2065. 5 3s are 15, 5 1s are 5 plus 1 6 and 5 4s are 20. So 2065. Then 2 is in tens place, so we do 413 into 20. So when we multiply, we'll get 8260. Then 6 is, which is in hundreds place, we'll multiply 413 into 600, we'll get 247,800. Okay, now to find the get the final answer, we add 2065 plus 8260 plus 247,800, we'll get 258,125. So the product of 413 and 625 is 258,125. Okay, so that was question A. Now coming to question B, 606 into 418. So here what we do, first we'll multiply 606 with 8, which is there in the ones place. So when I do that, I'll get 4,848. 8 6 are 48, so we write 8, carry over 4. 8 zeros are 0 plus 4 is 4, then 8 6 are 48, so 48,848. Okay, then 606 into 10. So that will be 6060. Okay, then 606 into 400 when I do. So we'll write first two zeros, then we'll multiply it by 4. 4 6 are 24, so write 4, carry over 2. 4 zeros are 0 plus 2 is 2, and 4 6 are 24, so 24. So when you add all this, 4848 plus 6060 plus 242,400, we'll get 253,308. Okay, so that is 253,308. Then next, 384 into 409. So first we'll multiply 384 with 9. So when we do that, we'll get 3456. So 9 4s are 36, write 6, carry over 3. 9 8s are is 72. Okay, 72 plus 2 is 72 plus 3 is 75. So 5, carry over 3. 9 3s are 27 plus 7 is 34. So 3, 4, 5, 6. Then we'll multiply 384 with 0. Any number multiplied by 0 is 0 only. So that will be 0. Then 384 into 400. Now 400 has 2 zeros. So we'll write 2 zeros in 1s and 10s and multiply 4 with 384. So when we multiply, we'll get 1536. So adding 3456 and 1,53,600, will get 1,57,056. Okay, so 384 into 409 is 1,57,056. All right, now next question, 827 into 252. So first we'll multiply 827 with 2, we'll get 1,654. Then what we'll do, we'll multiply 827 with 50. So we write 0 in 827 into 2, we'll get 1654. Then 827 into 50, we'll get 41,350. 5 is in tens place, so 50. Then 827 into 200, 2 is in hundreds place, so 200. When we multiply, we'll get 1,65,400. So 1654 plus 41,350 plus 1,65,400, you'll get 2,08,404. Okay, so this is how you do multiplication with 3-digit multipliers. Right now, we solved questions
A, B, C, and D in question number 2. So for your homework, what you have to do is you have to solve question E, F, G, and H. Okay, you have to solve questions E, F, G, H for your homework. So complete your homework, complete this question. In the next class, we will start with division. All right, we'll do division in the next class. All right, students, thank you. I'll see you all in the next class.